Welcome back to Colorado Sports Connection. We're talking with Rockies play-by-play radio announcer Jerry Schemmel. But before that, you had some time with the Denver Nuggets, and you also had some good years there, especially in the mid-90s.
Yeah, it was fun. I got there right when Dan Issel was taking over, and his second year, they went to the second round of the NBA playoffs after beating Seattle. That Seattle series was unbelievable. And after that, they lost Mutombo after the next season. Things kind of went downhill from there. But it looked like it was perfect timing for an announcer to come in with a good young team, and then it sort of just fell off. And then when Carmelo Anthony was drafted, it kind of picked the spirits back up. Team got better. They have not failed to make the playoffs ever since he's been here. So there were good times early and some lean years, and now some good times later on.
You know, and I'm glad you brought that up, the mid-90s and the years with Carmelo. Let's go back to the mid-90s when the Nuggets were the number 8 seed. They're going against the number 1 seed, Seattle. They go down 0-2. And this town, I mean, they're just dead. But then all of a sudden, it just picked up. And then for like about the next 2 weeks, it was just Nuggets fever.
It was something, wasn't it? It really was. And when you put all those circumstances together, it makes it even more incredible to me to look back on it today, Daryl, because Seattle was the number 1 seed. They had the best record in the NBA. Everybody's pointing at them as champs. George Karl was coaching them. They had Gary Payton, and I mean, they were loaded. And the Nuggets were the 8th seed. I think they had a 500 record. Maybe they might have been 42-40 in the regular season, but no one gave them a chance. Get blown out in game 1. Game 2 is a little bit closer in Seattle. They come home, they get games 3 and 4, and then they go back to Seattle for game 5. And even then, even going back to Seattle, people thought, no way, Seattle will clobber them going back to Seattle. And it didn't happen that way. And I think what people have to remember too is after the Nuggets, that was just a 5-game series back then. Now they play 7 games, best of 7, but then they took on Utah and nearly beat Utah in 7 games and lost game 7 out there. So it was quite a run. It was about as exciting as it gets around here for basketball.
And I'm glad you brought up that Utah series, because as a basketball fan, yes, that Seattle series, phenomenal. But that Utah series, that was great basketball, especially when you take a look at that Utah team when they had that Stockton and Malone.
Yeah, absolutely. And I remember John Stockton saying, I think after game 1 or maybe game 2, he said, hey, these Nuggets, I never forget this because I loved, it was my favorite player, John Stockton, said, these guys don't talk. There's no trash talk. They just go out and play. They love to play, and they play hard, and that's a dangerous team, and that's the way it turned out to be. They took Utah to 7 games, and I think of a couple things. I watched that game not too long ago, that game 7. A couple things go the Nuggets' way in that second half. It's a different story. It's a different result.
They had won like 22 games the year prior to that, but yet they were a very competitive team. Did you see this team going into the playoffs that following year?
I thought they would be good down the road a little bit because they had a very good young team. LaPhonso Ellis, as you mentioned, was kind of a rising star. They had their center in Mutombo, Bryant Stith. They had Robert Pack and Brian Williams. I mean, they had some odd characters, but you put them together as a group, and they were very and Mahmoud Abdul-Rauf, of course, back then Chris Jackson. They had a lot of talent, and I thought, boy, they're young, they're just starting to play together. A couple years down the road, they'll be really good. I didn't think in year 2 with Dan Issel they would be quite as good as they were.
You know, everybody brings up Carmelo and what he does, you know, in that arena, so electrifying. But maybe I'm just old school, this gentleman didn't play long enough. But to me, nobody brought the house down like LaPhonso Ellis. Mm-hmm. Nobody. And I've been following the Nuggets since 1980. Now, I know some people will say David Thompson, but the reason I say LaPhonso is because he played hard on both ends of the court, and he was dynamite.
Yeah, he was. I think he was a more talented player than people realize. He was very athletic his first couple years. Then he had the knee surgery, and he couldn't jump and run, and he got a little heavier. He thought he needed to be a power forward, lift a lot of weights, but I think he got away from the athleticism later in his career. But I agree with you. He was tremendous. I mean, I think there were a lot of people that criticized the draft pick when Bernie Bickerstaff picked him. Oh, he was And he was as, and you've met him, you know him, he's as good as a guy as he was as a basketball player. He was a great team player, great in the community, always had time for fans and the media like you and I. And he was a gem. I just texted him the other day. I saw him on ESPN doing the college basketball stuff now, which I think he does a great job at. And then I touched base with him the other day, and he's still doing great.
You know, and he had that fist pump before Tiger Woods. Remember after those dunks? You would see LaFonso giving that fist pump over to the fans.
I think Tiger stole that from him, didn't he?
I think so.
That's a fun original.
We're going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we'll have more with Jerry Schemmel right here on Colorado Sports Connection.